everyone, Ted Dale, Star Wars Nerd here. I hope you're doing well, and I want to thank you for joining me today, because we're going to watch another comic book that was dubbed over with sound effects, voices, music, and everything by Auditect and his crew. This is Star Wars Emissaries to Malastare Part 3. It says here underneath the video, as the peace negotiations for Lannik begin on Malastare, so does the Podrace. What is the connection between these two major events? Will peace be gained through diplomacy, or will the negotiations be short? Yeah, I have to do these little recaps before, but it looks like on this one, Auditect's got his recaps going now on these. But from what I gather, I went and rewatched the first two episodes again, and then I read the Wookieepedia articles on them. And basically what's going on right now is there's two factions that are warring, and they want to negotiate peace, and they want the Jedi to do that for them. And while they're there trying to negotiate peace, of course, there's other people in the background that are trying to kill the Jedi. So it's a basic, you know, everybody wants to kill the Jedi story. So anyway, I've got it set up over here. Let's just get to it. Part 3 of Emissaries to Malastare by Auditect and his crew. And here we go.
Last time on Emissaries to Malastare.
Greetings, one and all, and welcome to Malastare!
The flames hide us now. Aldar shoots a bulba now.
Do you think it was a good idea scheduling our peace negotiations with the Lannik?
Like the music in the background.
Same time cycle as these contemptible sporting events.
Can't think of what it reminds me of.
The more tension paid to the race, the less attention paid to the peace summit. The Red Yard Terrorists have the full cooperation of their Malastare Protectorate, friend Phoenix.
Ah, the esteemed Jedi Councilors. At last, you have arrived.
Is Asherad Het.
Those two beings?
Oh, and there's Peter Dinklage.
The Red Yard Terrorist. The other a sub-priest of the Ffib. Inquisitor.
What? They're shooting!
Yes! One does not need the force to see that, Red Carrier.
How did our assailants get blasters into the spaceport?
Either they hit them very well,
or
they were allowed to bring them in.
We've been planning this for a long time. Nothing can go wrong now. I assure you, by the time that the moons rise tomorrow, every last one of the Jedi delegates will be dead.
All right, that's the recap. So here we go. Done recap, I might say. That I love that music and everything. That just all went together. That's very cool. Asherad Het. That just freaks me out how the Dugs go around on their arms and use their legs as
how long are we going
arms.
To wait?
Or it's just weird.
The governor have let us in by now?
Your restlessness surprises me, Asherad. Your people spent centuries developing the virtue of patience.
This is not the desert, Master Key.
Asherad, are you all right, lad?
Oh!
Mind your temper, boy. Calm yourself.
Oppressive creatures, these Gamorrean guards. Wishing for trouble they are.
And thanks, Auditect, for explaining the colors of the lightsabers to me. It seems that Auditect says that this was made so long ago they didn't have the colors exactly worked out.
I'll not be attacked. Both you and my father taught me that, Master Key.
Stand aside, Padawan.
It's in 98. I'd believe that.
So brave, these handsome Gamorreans. So big you are. So strong. No harm the boy was meaning. Well, everything is. Your places again, you may.
That's very cool.
Trouble all
so could Yaddle give them. Better this way it is. After all, a mission of peace, is this not?
My thanks and apologies, Master. My people are children of the sand and wind. I'm not used to being behind walls.
You're on edge, Asherad.
Truth be told, we all are. Ending a war is serious business. We must look to the Force for strength and confidence.
May I share an observation with your padawan, Kiadi Mundi?
He would welcome your wisdom, Plo Koon. Right, Asherad?
Yes, Masters.
All walls hold danger. In palaces such as this, walls are built not only to keep enemies out, but also in. However, even in a prison, one can find wonderful things upon which to reflect. Observe the infinite patterns of the grain, the richness of color. Marvel at the elaborate carvings, and consider the time that was spent completing this artistry. I would suggest that you let your thoughts be piloted by the acknowledgement of beauty, not the apprehension of danger. A Jedi will certainly meet violence when it comes. Until then, the life around us begs our all.
But don't these decorations bother you a little, Master Plo? Surely the Gran Protectorate revels in its dominance over Malastare's natives.
I was going to say that's good advice for everything, because just take the time to look at the artwork in this. I really like the detail and everything. It's just, I really love this type of artwork. So much better than the High Republic artwork. I just can't stand that. And if you like it, that's great. More power to you.
The Grand Governor has offered a neutral ground where two warring factions can discuss peace. Such a gesture deserves our respect.
Yes. Until we find out what is in it for the Grands, anyway.
And for the terrorists.
Ah, my Jedi friends. Sorry for the delay.
The Lannik Prince and his party have taken their places. The Governor requests your presence in the arbitration chambers.
Governor Gujdim Wifshan of the Benevolent Grand Protectorate of
Malastare. I like the little lisp.
May we present
arbitrators
of the Jedi Council. As per our agreement with Supreme Chancellor Palpatine, they shall moderate the treaty between the rulers of the independent planet Lannik and the Red Yarrow rebels.
My warmest greetings to the Jedi representatives of the Galactic Republic.
I too welcome our esteemed emissaries. I am Senator Axmo, Malastare's Grand Delegate to the Galactic Senate. And this is the venerated Prince Ricardo Souffle IX, ruler of the planet and peoples of Lannik.
Yes, yes, very good. Warmest greetings, etc., etc. Is that the countryman whom I see among these religious ragamuffins? A free Lannik serving the Republic?
I am Evan Peel, a master of the Jedi Order and a long-term member of the Jedi High Council.
It's a great voice.
When I took the Jedi Oath, I pledged my hands to the laws of the Republic and my mind to the ways of the Force. But my heart will ever belong to my homeworld. I knew both your father and your grandfather, and saw you many times when you were a child. With your military advisor Hutar Zash did I serve. He was captain of the palace guard.
Yes, Master Evan. It is good to see you again.
Evan Peel, you say? No, I'm sorry, I still don't remember you.
You should, Your Majesty. When terrorist assassins stormed the palace, this Jedi saved your parents' lives, and those of my parents, the Corellian ambassadors to Lannik.
Did he? Too bad. I might have been prince much sooner, had he spared the effort. And who are you, my bold beauty?
He's a dick!
Adi Gallia of Corellia, Jedi Master and Chief Negotiator for this treaty. My parents longed for a settlement between your government and the rebels. I've come to finish their work.
And I am Master Mace Windu, Senior Counselor of the Jedi High Council, and acting director for this mission. Might I ask, when the Red IRO's representatives will be arriving?
We are here, magician. Why the rush? You have someplace else to go.
We are Jedi, guardians of peace and law throughout the galaxy, serving others as we are asked to serve. We do not take these proceedings lightly, nor should you. Whom am I addressing?
Zuck. His name is Zuck.
Ah, Master Even Peel. I am flattered that you remember me, old creature. I remember you too, but then I gave you something to make you easy to recognize, didn't I?
I could have.
It looks like he's got a scar across his nose too.
Or had my eye replaced with a prosthetic one. I did not. I kept these scars to remind me of the 8 who fought in the throne room that day. 6 died. Only 1 being walked out. The other ran.
Ooh,
are you
burn.
To put me into a fight, Jedi?
I do not goad, my Chazak. It is counter to the teachings of the Force. The truth, however, is not.
Those were different times, even Peel. Times of war. I'm not running now. I'm too tired for it. The Red Yaru are weary of fighting. It's time for peace.
The fledged beast also gets tired, but it cannot shed its hide.
If it's peace both sides want, then peace you shall have. We Jedi are here to see that neither side is overcharged for its cost.
Well said, Windu. Such inspiring sentiments should guide us well. Shall we begin?
Masters! Something is wrong here.
Yes, Hutarod. The air curdles with a feeling of impending disaster.
I sense this also, my friends. Perhaps the time has come for all of us to succumb to your earlier apprehensions of danger, young one.
Careful, my Padawan. Remain alert.
Podracing us! GG lands water! Who dearful methane waste of Malastare! Starting point, boon in our race of full Vinta Harvest Classic!
That's right, babe. It's the event we've all waited for.
I love that. I love that. Translating the language. Such detail.
If you whom this bull come to Dekaha.
Let's see what's happening.
The androids everywhere. Oh, that'd be cool. Have a little drone flying all over watching the race. I bet you can get some great shots from something like that. Very cool. I love it. Oh, burn.
Oops, a little mishap on the field. Luckily, no one was seriously hurt.
Let's say for his info.
That Sebulba seems to attract accidents like a lodestar.
He who beat Todae cancels the guild of Meres Beta und Noctatoi.
This season's finals are season pros. Most are survivors of the exciting Wookieepedia Classic on Tatooine. We have Aldar Vito. Pinto Pagali. The local grand favorite, Mahonic. Gerundo. Juan Sanded.
That's cool. That's something I need to learn how to do, is the pan and scan like that, move it around. I just haven't got around to it. I really need to get to that.
Hey, it looks like the race is about to begin. A true long-standing tradition. Nuptosh has taken his position atop the starting spire. Racer, start your afterburners.
I can hear the pods powering up. Like that! That shot there, that is awesome! I love that!
In return, of course, we'll concede the territory that we captured in Palesia.
Concede? Your terrorists will concede?
Those lands were never yours to begin with! Legally, they are in possession of the Lannik crown!
Your Highness, I think that Zog only means to...
Silence, Hutar, you withered old Nuna! You're the royal advisor! That means you're only to advise when I ask for it!
Your Highness, with all due respect, I suggest that you consider the proposal for its value to your people, rather than for any offense in phrasing.
The Prince of Lannik needs no help from Jedi freaks and mystics!
Wow.
I'm only here because my advisor Hutar thought it best! Now I see it was a mistake!
Your Highness, please take your seat and compose yourself. The clerk will strike those last remarks.
Objection! Allow Prince Ricardo to speak his mind, and enter his comments into the official record, for all to see.
Tisk, tisk. The Red Yarrow is saddened by the Prince's outburst. The Red Yarrow wishes only peace.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Some too should be entered into the transcripts.
We can go no further today. Let us adjourn until tomorrow. Everyone needs a chance to calm down.
Nice and calm, Miss Windu.
We shall summon a shuttle to take you to your apartments.
Advisor Hutar would like to offer the Jedi the use of his personal shuttles. Is that not so, sir?
Yes, by all means. They await outside.
Master!
Again,
what are those
just
people doing?
Take a chance to look at the artwork and the details in the background.
Strange it is that the negotiations would be scheduled during a time of such activity.
We'd better hurry. The first lap of this race passes right through this area.
How have you been, Hutar?
As well as can be expected, Pyr. Things changed when the young prince took the throne. It's a new world. The old ways are dead. Someday the Lannik of old shall return, but sacrifices will have to be made.
Sacrifices, Hutar?
Look, a Podracer!
It is time, old man. The cam droids are here. We must do what must be done.
What?
For the Red Yarrow and Lannik's freedom!
They're my faults. We are betrayed.
But they are learned not to accept shuttle rides from strangers.
I'm sorry, Owen. For once, the terrorists are right. It's the only
way
to regain our world. At least I'll die with you.
Well.
Too late, old man. There's nothing you can do to stop us.
No.
Slice the boat in half. Or the... Yeah. Wow. That's one way to do it.
Get them!
I've made a little force bubble around the guy and threw him, but, you know. That's still cool.
I take this wasn't part of your plan, Evan!
They gonna land on Saboba? Kinda. Well, that was cool. Is that it? No, that's it. All right. Well, very cool. That is awesome. Good job, Auditect. That is just too damn cool. I wish all comics were done this way. I wish all comics were done this way because I just think more people would watch them and read them and just enjoy these old stories. These stories are so great back then that Dark Horse Comics did back with Lucasfilm in the day. And it's just awesome. The storylines that are in there, and it goes all the way back to the beginning. If you go back to the Golden Age of the Sith, which I'm eventually going to get to, but yeah, Auditech's doing a great job. I wish I could hire him and his whole crew just to make these professionally all day long, because there's different storylines I'd love to see done just to be able to get these stories out there and get more people to see it and enjoy the extended universe that was Star Wars that Disney got rid of. And just, it's just awesome. And the way Auditech puts these together is just awesome. Taking all the audio from these different people. And he's told me before that these people are all in different places. They could be anywhere around the world, but they're not, you know, together in the same room. And somehow or other, he edits that so it sounds like they're all at least in the same room recording this. It's not like, you know, somebody sounds like they're in a closet. One guy sounds like he's in the bathroom. The other guy sounds like he's in the kitchen down the hall. You know, it's just, it doesn't echo. It's all perfect. And just the voices go well with the characters, it seems like. They don't seem odd, you know. I didn't, when Evan Peel started talking and he had that low, deep voice, you wouldn't really automatically think of like a shorter person having a deep voice like that, but it just felt natural and not like odd or awkward like some other things I've seen. I've seen some other cartoons in the past and things done that, you know, I'm sure you've seen things like that. It just don't seem right. But everything in this just seems great, and I'm just loving it. So, again, I'm rambling. Hats off to you, Auditect. This is awesome. Keep up the great work. Enjoy your vacation. Thanks again for joining me. I am Ted, the old Star Wars nerd. Please leave a comment below. Click that like button. Click subscribe button. Click that bell for notifications. Do the same on Auditect's channel. Go over there and check out all his stuff. He doesn't just have these. He's got a lot of other stuff, too. Go check him out, all right? Thanks again for joining me, and until next time, you take care, all right? Thanks. Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in, I really appreciate it. If you enjoy my videos, please click that like button, leave a comment below, and make sure you're subscribed so you can get notifications of all my future content. All of you are so great, and I want to thank each and every one of you for your support. Thanks for stopping in, and I hope to see you again real soon. Take care.